big reasons barefoot running and minimalist running takes a leading role in preventing impact-related injury is because the multiple sensory inputs at the feet are actually very necessary in helping you maximize your mechanical effectiveness by enabling you to develop a proper forefoot strike landing. And the sensory inputs also activate wide-ranging reflexes throughout the body that helps you avoid generating damaging impact stressors as compared with running in really thick cushioned standard running shoes. For instance, there's a significant difference in impact pressure acting across the foot between runners who run barefoot or even in barefoot-like running shoes, like minimalist running shoes, versus runners who run in thickly cushioned conventional running shoes, such that runners in thickly cushioned running shoes were found to generate more pressure stress on the foot. But generally speaking, as we so well know, injury prevention efforts in running mainly target factors such as reducing impact stress by adding more layers of underfoot cushioning. However, what's so scientifically interesting is that many studies, which are all linked down below the video in the description box, have literally found the same basic conclusion and troubling trend, such that decreases in ground feel at the feet when you run leads to unusually high foot pressure, especially on the midfoot, and also the softer and the thicker the underfoot cushioning of a running shoe correlates with greater bursts of high pressure stress on the foot, which could easily increase the risk of a bony fracture in the foot, but even worse, foot injuries at the expense of the burst of high pressure loads on the foot isn't just limited to the foot. It may actually ripple up the lower leg, causing injury there as well. In fact, a 2011 study in the journal Gait Posture and a 2004 study in the Journal of American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons found that high peak pressure at the midfoot was a major risk factor for medial tibial stress syndrome in long distance runners who ran in conventional thick cushioned running shoes. Another compounding problem is that thick underfoot cushioning masks the feel of high impact during running. So essentially, runners are completely unaware that their cushioned running shoes are actually causing them to produce damaging impact forces on the foot as well as on the leg. In keeping with this, pioneering work on barefoot versus shod or shoe running by Dr. Stephen Robbins found that runners in thickly cushioned running shoes produced more pressure stress on the foot on account of the cushion thickness significantly decreased transmission of mechanical transients, which are adequate stimuli to proprioceptors that help you land lighter. In simple terms, the thicker the underfoot cushioning, the less your feet can actually feel the ground, the more downward force the foot produces with the ground when you run. This is because the foot forcibly tries to push itself down and through the compressible underfoot cushioning when running. This is why there's greater downward force of the foot at landing. Therefore, more pressure stress is produced on the foot when you run in thickly cushioned running shoes as compared with running barefoot. Running barefoot, on the other hand, or even in barefoot-like very thin minimalist running shoes, was found to produce the opposite effect at landing during running, in that instead of landing hard on the ground, the foot reflexively lands much lighter, as there's more than enough adequate sensory stimuli acting on the underfoot to activate what is called the impact avoidance behavior reflex, which stops you from pounding the foot into the ground and instead makes you land a lot lighter by making you pull your foot up quickly off the ground. The same positive effect can be seen when running in very thin, minimalist barefoot-like running shoes, whereby a 1996 study in the journal Clinical Biomechanics found that running on harder surfaces in thin, minimalist footwear resulted in stark reductions in peak foot pressure on account of the runners reflexively adjusted their landing intensity to land lighter. And again, this is because the heightened sensory stimulation on the underfoot activates the impact avoidance behavior reflex more fully. As a result, your default neuromechanical reaction at landing is to reflexively land with your foot in a safer position that actually stops you from producing injurious impacts. What I mean by this is the foot ends up landing closer to your center of mass, which is your hips. The foot also lands with better forefoot strike precision. Out of this, there's reductions in multiple impact forces at once because there's a shorter break period at landing. There's less jolt when you forefoot strike when you run because there's a greater smoothness in foot placement. There's, as I just mentioned, less downward force of the foot. And also the foot essentially wrestles a lot less with the ground because there's a faster withdrawal retraction or removal of the foot off the ground, which results in a high step rate, which means the foot spends less time lingering on the ground and more time in the air. The net effect of all of this is real protection against dangerous rises in pressure stress on the foot, but not just limited to the foot. Less impact and mechanical stress may be projected onto the shins as well as the knee. So all in all, these studies are another revealing indicator that by running barefoot, a runner can actually protect themselves from high impact through these reflexes that make the changes necessary to ensure that your mechanics are brought back into balance and alignment to effectively soften up your forefoot strike landing. And with more barefoot running experience that you do, these reflexive responses become hardwired in your muscle memory, which means it will be easier for you to uphold these immediate mechanical improvements curated by running barefoot for when you do run or compete in shoes. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't already, where you'll stay more informed on forefoot strike running versus heel strike running, as well as more informed on the performance and the health benefits of barefoot running and minimalist running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.